So Son of a Faith was a social commentary song, really, for me. It was inspired by a kind of, not just religion, people in power, politicians, anyone in power, and how people like that kind of fool people and take the piss, right? And that's really what I'm trying to get at the song. It's not to offend anyone, it's not knocking any particular religion. I've got no problems with religion, but I've got a problem with people that take advantage of the religion or of their position of power. So Son of a Faith kind of comes from the term son of a bitch. Stop the Messing, our first single off the Introvertigo album. You know, it worked great for us, and our second single, Son of a Faith, it's very, very different. It's still in the blues rock genre. I think both of them are in the blues rock genre. But this one, I think, kind of leans a little bit more to the classic blues rock sound. It's a little heavier. It's a little bit more in your face. And, you know, also, you know, the content of the song, the music kind of had to serve, you know, what the lyrics of the song were. So when we were kind of coming up with concepts for the video for Son of a Faith, we had to tread quite lightly, because obviously as soon as you put a song like this into a visual format, things can become offensive quite quickly. That's as simple as that. You'll see from the video, I mean, at the end of the day, there's a heaven after all, you know? And yeah, I'll just leave it at that. Recently, the Introvertigo album, we got this fantastic accolade at the end of 2016, which was like such a huge honor. It was voted the number one album by Blues Rock Review in the USA. And it's awesome, because I'm the only artist ever to, you know, have that happen twice, because Dear Silence Thieves back in 2015 won the same award. And obviously it's a huge, huge honor. You know, that first award really opened up so many doors for us, you know, on the international front. And, you know, obviously I'm not necessarily in it for the awards, but obviously to end a year off with a fantastic accolade like that, it kind of is almost like a pat on the back for all the hard work that you spend in the studio, all the time you live on the road. This April, May, we are heading back to the UK and Europe to promote Introvertigo and our new single, Son of a Faith. I love playing in the UK and I love playing in Europe. I find the audiences just really cultured. It is just incredible for me. I love being there. I love playing there. This time I'm bringing a fantastic band with me. They're from Germany and they are fantastic players. They really, really are. So I look forward to hitting the road with them. And I think it's just gonna be a great tour. I think playing Introvertigo live has really settled now. It's, you know, when you release a new album, it takes a long while for those songs to settle on a live platform. And I really feel now that the songs have settled and really, you know, kind of cemented their place, right, on the live thing. So I cannot wait to be back. One of the interesting things about touring UK and Europe is, you know, I haven't been touring there for too long, right? So, you know, it's kind of an adjustment in a way, because, you know, in South Africa, you know, we're playing to, you know, possibly crowds 4,000 or 5,000 people, and obviously now we're coming across to Europe and the UK, and obviously playing to far smaller rooms and far smaller people. But obviously, you know, I started off doing that, and it's, you know, smaller audiences and smaller rooms have a, you know, there's a charm to it, right? There really, really is. It's more intimate. You really kind of get to know the audience a lot better than you do when it's on a bigger stage with a bigger audience. And I kind of like that intimacy. I really do. I think it brings something else out in your performance that doesn't happen on bigger stages.